Certainly there's a freedom with this record, a sense of liberation. There's no fear. There's a defiant grit and spirit to it, I think. The last record, Hell Breaks Loose, was the beginning of a whole new chapter for me as a songwriter and an artist.
Critically, it was a very loved record. It seemed to kind of resonate with a lot of people, more than any project I'd been involved in.
I'd been out on the road a lot, and I was really enjoying it, but it became quite obvious to me that I wasn't really making any progress on the new record. And I knew, again, that I would have to find a way to cut myself off from civilization. I found this really beautiful house on the Hawkesbury River that's only accessible by boat. You're completely cut off, there's no phone or email. I think that sense of removal is when I start feeling creative. And I would just spend 3 or 4 days there at a time, some wine and some whiskey and some fishing rods and a guitar. Let's go hide from the people we know, so we don't have to let it show. I started scribbling, and then this song started emerging. And then both of my rods are in the water, took off. Do I stop writing? I'm on a roll and catch these fish, or do I let them go and finish the song? So I tried to do both, you know, scribbling, pulling with one hand and then the other one. And then in the end, I lost both the fish, but I got the song. So I guess that's more important. Friday crowd really gets beneath my skin. This cover band don't even know which key they're in, and it's driving me mad, driving me mad.
Shane emailed me a bunch of songs that he'd very roughly recorded at home and instantly just wanted to get into the studio and start cutting tracks.
We still, to this day, we've nearly finished. We still haven't really had a conversation about the direction of the record or of any particular song even. They just kind of form. Why am I here singing a song for a sad girl? Why ain't I writing poetry about a smile? Why ain't she living like the king of the whole world, while everything around her is going out of style? And there's a lot more positive things to write about in my life these days, but I still find a negative aspect of them to focus on. But, you know, fuck it. That's what songwriters do, isn't it? That's what makes me want to write songs. If I'm happy, I'm going outside to, you know, play football or be in the sun, you know. We're crooks and we're cronies, failures and
phonies. We're one trick ponies. You've got to mix it up, and that's what we've done on this album. We've really taken what we know works and then push the limits of that. God's own army gonna hunt me down. God's own army gonna hunt me down. Not even the devil will take me now. God's own army gonna hunt me down.
Largely, they're still personal songs, hopes and fears and dreams and disappointments. I've always written what I know about or what I think I know about. That's what all my ex-girlfriends said, what you think you know. I would quit my drinking, and I would sell all my guitars. I've danced twice in my life with the aim of impressing a girl, and not only failed miserably as far as impressing the girl, but I also looked like a total dick. I would be happy to go to the ends of the earth for you and do all sorts of things. That is the one deal breaker I won't ever do. Certainly there's a freedom with this record, and all the early records I made were just completely instilled with fear. What I love now about the records that we've been making the last couple of years is that there's no fear involved. There's almost an ambivalence and a defiance against, fuck, I don't care what you think about this record, we'll just make the one that we want to make and that we would like to listen to, you know?